very proud to be able to come and talk to you about the fashion industry and the plans we have for reinventing it here. Our goal is to make Austin the fashion capital of the world. And we're going to do that by utilizing technology to give us an advantage over importing products here into the U.S. I'm here also to tell you the good, the bad, and the ugly about our industry. The good is that we do $2.5 trillion globally in fashion throughout the world. We also employ 75 million people globally. The bad is we are one of the second most destructive industries to the environment. 85% of the products that we produce end up in landfills. 60% of the products we have polyester. We produce 8 to 10% of the carbon weights for the whole world. We also destroy 20% of the water waste in the whole world for our industry. We have to change that. What about if fashion had intelligence and wasn't just cute? What if we had an opportunity to transform wearable technology into our lifestyle? Right now, by the year 2028, the IoT wearable technology business is a $150 billion industry. And right now, we're on the leading edge of it right here in Austin, Texas. Our focus as a company is wearable technology. We look at how to integrate nanobiotech into all of our products. We just had a project that we were able to launch at NASA about a month ago. We have a new fiber. It's a crystal fiber. We harvest the heat from your body, then that heat is turned into far infrared. The far infrared is directed back into your skin. It decreases your cortisol level and increases your nitric oxide level, which means it decreases your stress and tension and increases your ability to function. We have created a motorcycle jacket that has fiber optics lighting on the back, and that fiber optics lighting is connected to your phone through GPS. It automatically turns the lights on when you need the signal, and it vibrates on the shoulders to tell you which direction to turn. We took a smaller version of that for the kids with the scooters and the motorbikes downtown, and basically it has a motion detector in the sleeve that they can turn their hands up and down to turn the signal lights on the back, and then when the signal lights are not on, it does visibility so you can see those kids running around downtown on those scooters. This is one of the focuses. The other thing is we're into energy harvesting. Energy harvesting, natural energy, and reusing is what we're really focused in on all of our products. Right now, we've got solar beads that we're incorporating into the products that can collect the energy for us, and then we also have lithium-ion batteries that we can put in the fabric and be able to power it with solar beads. The way that we're going to address the changes of our industry is we're looking at AR, VR, MR, XR as our main focus as far as the technology. Internet of Things, everything that we're making now will be connected or has some type of biotech effect to it. We're using artificial intelligence and machine learning to do analytics for a lot of the products that we're making. Applications that we can scan you with your phone, that you can actually download the app, scan yourself with the phone. It'll create an avatar of you. We use artificial intelligence to perfect the avatar. Then that avatar, you can go into our software and design made-to-measure clothing. We have 100 trillion SKUs that you can pick from to design an outfit. We also use sustainable fabrics and fibers within our products that we offer you to pick from. You then go into our software and you design your product. You can decide on any type of product you want, any type of lining you want, anything that you want to do to this product, you can pretty much do it with our software. 7 days later, the product's made. 3 to 5 days later, it's at your front door. One product, not 100,000, not a million. And the biggest problem we have now is overproduction of products. This will help us to eliminate that problem. And then we're creating bots and robots to assist us in the production to offset the cost of production that we're having in the factories in Asia and South America. We're looking at putting 150 more of the facilities that we have here throughout the United States and helping to reshore. We're also working on all kinds of systems to set up and be able to create our own fibers here. Right now, even with us returning it here, we're still having to produce our fibers in China because we don't have the facilities here to develop the fabrics for us, but we're developing those mills now. We're also going to be able to create more jobs here in the U.S. What we're looking at in reshoring the industry is reinventing the retail industry. Right now, you've got a pretty passive industry What we're looking at doing is adding all the new technologies so that you have an interactive experience anytime you go into a retail store. We've got all the different areas that we're working with. We're putting in mixed reality shopping, 3D measurements, bots and avatars, augmented reality shopping, holograms. We have a new sensor that we're about to introduce that we can actually project an immersive, interactive hologram of you anywhere in the world. And it's immersive and interactive. We're using robots for monitoring of inventories, monitoring of customers, and artificial intelligence are all included into these products. And then we're also doing interactive shopping SKUs, so you can have interactivity within the SKUs and be able to collect data from the interaction with the customer in the SKU. So we've got a lot of different products that we're bringing in to reinvent this whole industry here in the U.S. A lot of the things, you'll already see a lot of it in China, and we're out playing catch up on some of it, but we also have the ability to jump ahead of them because we have a lot more creativity in this country. Web 3.0, Europe just put a standard in that any products going into Europe have to have a visible life cycle of the product from concept all the way to the disposal of the product. That's a game changer. We're fortunately already in that game. We're creating software on Web3 that we can actually monitor the software from the concept to the end of the life cycle and be able to monitor how much carbon use is being developed through whether it's transportation, whether it's the product of going back into the earth. So basically, we're totally looking at this industry and trying to revamp it and change it. The incubator at ACC was built for the community. And basically, it's an advanced manufacturing facility. Everything that I've talked to you about today, you can actually do at ACC now. What we're having to do is retrain the kids now so that they have the ability to utilize this new technology and have a leading edge over our competitors globally. And when we can do this, then we can become more sustainable. And that's what I'm looking to do here by making Austin the forefront of all this new technology that's coming to existence. We spent $15 million developing this facility, and this facility right now is one of three in the world. Gerber gave us $13.5 million for their project. They originally gave us $6.5 million, and when they came in and saw what we were doing to develop this technology here in Austin, they came back and gave us $13.5 million. The city of Austin partnered in and took over and gave us all of the money to maintain the product here, and ACC gave us the facility and the training for the facility. So that's how we try to work the trisector down. And then we're extending it to all the high schools so that they'll be able to do dual credit at the schools now. So we're building out this program from the ground up, and I just need a lot of help from the community right now because I'm running out. I've got to run a business and try to do all this. So I need help from the community to continue to build this, to expand the programs that we've already developed here into other schools. We have a program at McCallum High School now. We started it 8 years ago. We had 20 kids. We now have 250 kids. Those kids are getting scholarships to Parsons, New York, to Milan, France, all over the world now. So we're developing these programs here in the city, but we need to expand these programs to other schools. And when I see these kids going off to Parsons, going off to all the great schools, and I think that that's an opportunity that we're creating here. And we have the opportunity to give more children that opportunity. And right now, we also have to train the kids for the new jobs that are coming available because they're not getting the training that they need for all the new technologies that we're about to introduce into the world. To get the community involved in helping to develop the microeconomies that we have the opportunity to develop right now and build out a complete new ecosystem that's going to be sustainable for everyone. I want to thank you for having me. I appreciate the time. Have a great day.